Hi, welcome to Take 5, where we daily consider devotional thoughts from Oswald Chambers' book, My Utmost for His Highest. Today is December 9th. The title of today's devotional is The Opposition of the Natural. Those who are Christ's have crucified the flesh with its passion and desires, Galatians 5, verse 24. You may argue of there being a natural lifestyle, not really wrapped up in Christ, but which is all right to live because it's only natural to do those things. Dr. Chambers is going to present today fresh considerations regarding what we see as living a natural human life in light of Christ's expectations for us. To the natural mind, what Chambers says may seem extraordinary and even exaggerated. It will appear as something that certainly God couldn't mean, but he does. Chambers begins, the natural life is not sinful, but we must abandon sin, having nothing to do with it in any way whatsoever. Sin belongs to hell and the devil. I, as a child of God, belong to heaven and to God. It sounds as though he is presenting separate matters, the natural life and a sinful life. His next statement draws them together. It is not a question of giving up sin, but of giving up my right to myself, my natural independence, and my self-will. This is where the battle has to be fought. Now is when you hear, wait, is Chambers saying that living a regular life is sinful? What O.C. is saying is the things that are right, noble, and good from the natural standpoint are the very things that keep us from being God's best. We have been taught to understand that for sin to be sin, it must be bad, but sin is actually not the best. People will contend that they live with behavior that is not bad, and to the natural mind, it likely isn't, but God wants us to look beyond that. Chambers shares that once we come to understand that natural moral excellence opposes or counteracts surrender to God, we bring our soul into the center of its greatest battle. When you begin showing a Christian that areas of their good life in the natural realm still fall short of the glory of God, this will be likely met with dismay and dismissed as too extreme. O.C. points out very few of us would debate what is filthy, evil, and wrong, but we do debate over what is good. It is the good that opposes the best. The higher up the scale of moral excellence a person goes, the more intense the opposition to Jesus Christ. The nearer one draws to Christ, the greater it is to be the crucifixion, rather, of the desires of the flesh. And this intensity for the spiritual will be resisted by the natural, particularly in the Christian. As O.C. says, the cost of your natural life is not one or two things, but everything. Jesus said, if anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself. That is, he must deny his right to himself, and he must realize who Jesus Christ is before he will bring himself to do it. This is the key to the laying down of self, the personal growing greater realization of who Christ is. The more important is Jesus to you, the more you will cast aside self. Chambers warns, beware of refusing to go to the funeral of your own independence. We see this so often in the Bible readings, words such as, there must not be any filthiness and silly talk or coarse jesting, and to put aside anger, wrath, malice, slander, and abusive speech, and much more. We read and gloss over it as being a godly suggestion, but not fully expected. Consider, though, if it's in Scripture, why it wouldn't be intended to be kept. God doesn't expect us to keep his word. The argument can be that this is where grace enters the picture, for God knows, as in the Old Testament, we fail in obedience. Here's the kicker. Unlike they, we are ones who are filled with the Spirit that raised Christ from the dead. We are ones of entitlement. We have empowerment as no one else ever had. We do not have sin, but wait. We do not have to sin, but we want to. It's only natural. O.C. notes, the natural life is not spiritual, and it can only be made spiritual through sacrifice. Sacrifice means giving up of good for what is best. If we do not purposely sacrifice the natural, the supernatural can never become natural to us. Finish this sentence. It's only natural for someone to. Does the natural bring surrender to God? OC says there is no high or easy road. Each of us has the means to accomplish it entirely in his own hands. It is not a question of praying, but of sacrificing and therefore performing his will. One may ask, is everything in our life supposed to glorify God? Paul answered that, whether then you eat or drink or whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. The answer is yes, whatever we do is to be for his glory. Thanks for being here today. Now may God's grace and peace be ours as we seek to live our utmost for his highest. Have a great day and we'll see you tomorrow. Bye now.